finally, I will be able to show the strength. Oh wow, I guess cockpit is always better than control seat, huh? No, it's more complicated than that. What? You don't get it. What? It's really hard to explain. Hey guys, so I was doing some combat tests for my space station with a friend earlier. Then I realized I haven't made a video talking about the biggest combat pros and cons between using cockpits and using control seats. Alright, so most of you probably know that you can have, you know, pressurized cockpit that can have its own oxygen, but in combat situations that doesn't matter that much because combat or battles on space engineer don't usually last that long. So, you know, if you got some oxygen depressurization when your armor got breached or whatever, you'll most likely still have enough oxygen for the rest of the battle. The cockpits also usually have more health than the control seats, but that also doesn't matter that much. Since, you know, the armor of the ship would be the thing that makes the biggest difference in that aspect. So, the biggest meaningful difference between cockpits and control seats is that the cockpits usually have more attachment points. So for example, if I shoot at the control seat here, you guys can see that the control seat got detached from the grid. And well, if I shoot at the thing below the control seat there, I mean below the cockpit there, you guys can see that it's still attached to the grid. Now, this might make you assume that the cockpit is objectively better for combat situations compared to the control seats, but you also need to consider that a cockpit on space engineers costs 150 PCU, and most of the control seats on space engineers only cost 50 PCU. So for a single enclosed cockpit, you can have 3 control seats. So if one of them got detached by an enemy shot, for example, you can quickly go to the other one. And this can be beneficial because even though the cockpit got more attachment point, it still doesn't make it more likely to survive enemy fire. If, you know, the cockpit itself got shot by an enemy fire compared to a control seat. So in that kind of situation where the control point itself got shot instead of the attachment point, then well, having more of them would actually be more beneficial. And you know, not to mention, you can always put more armor on the attachment point of the control seat. This will make it less likely for the attachment point to get destroyed. And this can also be cheaper on PCU compared to using a cockpit. So, by understanding those pros and cons I mentioned, you guys can see how this is all very situational depending on what kind of build you have and what kind of situation you expect yourself to get into. Let's say that you got a very tight space constraint on your ship and you don't have any room for extra control seats, then in that situation, using a cockpit can be beneficial. And well, if you don't have any PCU constraint whatsoever, then using a cockpit is objectively better because you'll have, you know, more attachment points and because the cockpit is stronger than the control seat. But well, if you have PCU or space constraint like I mentioned earlier, then the difference in the amount of attachment points makes it really situational. Also, just keep in mind though, if you need to switch between control seats because one got detached or whatever, that will also take some time. So that's also something to consider. So yeah, that's the biggest combat pros and cons, or you know, the biggest meaningful combat difference between using control seats and cockpits on space engineers. I should stop making videos where the answer can get convoluted. Remember when I tried to explain the math of combat efficiency?